how many times of time we are born, how much of our lives, how much of who we actually think we are, is based on comparing ourselves to everybody else. It's really something. Now, I'm not ruling out that there's a natural, quite normal need to do that. We are amongst other people, and we do see things we like in other people, the way they stand, the way they walk, the way they, their mannerisms and so on. I'm not saying that this has to somehow be, you know, stopped. It can't be stopped. We are mimics, and it's a good thing. But what has happened is we have psychologically lost our own sense of self, or let's say that the self that we imagine we are, right, the pseudo-self that I keep talking about, is literally not our true inherent self, because of course it's simply grammatically illogical. The self is the self. It requires no other person or no other entity in order to exist. So the self that we have, that is made up of all these endless comparisons. How many teenager kids do you know that don't have a poster on their wall of some rock star or movie star? This is what I'm talking about. It's so ubiquitous. And I'm not saying it's all negative, we just have to observe that this is the case, that the thing that we call the self is a total farce. And that simple, basic, philosophical and psychological understanding that we inhabit a kind of a costume when we walk around. And the better we perform, the better society likes us, and then we smile because society smiles, and what we do is we go, get away, self. Don't make your presence known to me, for goodness sake. I don't want to be you anymore. I don't want to be myself anymore. And if you examine very closely the behavior of children, I'll give you an example of the other day, because I notice it all the time. I was sitting at a cafe, talking with a friend. A few tables away was a family with a kid. And the kid was about probably 4 years old and started to just mill around the table. Just started to walk around the tables and touch the glasses and just look and peer at other people. And believe me, that kid couldn't get 4.5 feet away before up jumps Adolf Hitler and comes screeching over, grabs the kid, goes, come over here, you know, get back over here. So that is tyranny.
Yeah.
I don't care what way you cut it. That child cannot physically go 4 feet away from its controllers because it's under control. And the mere simple, random, spontaneous act of no trust is being projected to that child. Oh, a truck's going to run over it, don't you know? Jesus, it's going to be hit by a thunderbolt, don't you know, if the mother doesn't go over and grab it. I mean, just all hell is going to break loose. It's going to implode in a ball of fire.